money market funds, as they are designed and as they're positioned, are very short-term products on the fixed income side. As such, they reflect short-term interest rate changes very, very quickly. So as interest rates at the federal level have gone from 0 to over 3%, they are now reflecting those same sorts of levels within money market funds. Generally speaking, when the Fed raises interest rates, you'll see money market funds raise in a similar manner, 25 basis points, 50 basis points, 75 basis points, reflective of the Fed moves within something that is a day to a month, depending upon the weighted average maturity of those products. So they're market-based products owning market securities that reflect market interest rates. Deposit products reflect the administered rate of that particular banking institution. But in all instances, it generally follows a directional change for short-term interest rates. That deposit beta is only historically about 40%. That means that for every 100 basis points of short-term rate increases that you see in the short-term rates market, you're only gonna see 40 basis points of that reflected in a deposit product versus a money market fund that is going to, with a short lag, reflect all 100 basis points. So that's the basic difference, and that's why in a steady to a rising rate environment like we have been in over the course of a year now at this point, we basically are going to see something that is reflective of where short-term interest rates are and how quickly they're changing in a money market fund.